If you're looking to upgrade your stream and add a huge amount of production value without putting any effort in, well then you're gonna love instant replays. This video is gonna show you guys how with one click of a button, you're able to not only save, but play back those amazing victories or hilarious fails all while live. And I have a bonus tip at the end about how you can use all of those instant replays to build your social media and start making your stream more discoverable. Yeah, it's a big video. Let's go. Hey, I'm Eljay with streamscheme.com. I'm also a variety streamer over at twitch.tv/LJM_. There are links to both those in the description if you want to check me out while live or any of our guides over at streamscheme.com. Today, I'm going to be showing you guys how to set up instant replays, but we're going to be taking it a step further. I'm going to be showing you guys how to add effects to your replays so they can be black and white for fails, they can be slow motion, or you can add effects such as our free VHS overlay that shows an instant replay that you can download from our Discord entirely for free. This free little effect actually also matches our glitch aesthetic overlay as well as our glitch stingers. So if you want to, guys, those are also in the Discord and you can download those easily. Now, if you're an OBS user and you want to add instant replays, you're going to have to go check out the video linked in the description. It takes you to Gaming Careers. He has a fantastic tutorial on it. This video is going to be focusing on Streamlabs OBS and the effects that you can add to them. I also got the idea to make and include the VHS overlay from Gaming Careers, so full credit to him. As I said, check him out. He's fantastic. There's so much stuff in the description, including time codes. Feel free to skip ahead to whatever section you want. But if you do miss a step in this video, you're probably going to get lost. So let's finally get into it. The very first step to this entire video is enabling instant replays if you haven't already. To do this, you're going to go to your settings, select output, and then select replay buffer. You'll want to click enable replay buffer if you haven't already, and then set your maximum replay time. Now, your default replay time might be different to what I have set currently on screen, and that is totally fine. The important thing to remember is the longer the replay time you set here, the more resource intensive it is going to be. Meaning if you make it too long, it might cause you to lag, and every time you save a replay, you'll be saving the clip to your PC, so it takes up space. I have my replay buffer set to 5 seconds because it isn't resource intensive, and I'm mainly using it to clip deaths and fails, which often don't take longer than 5 seconds to happen. But there are really good reasons to have longer clips, which I will explain at the end of the video when I show you how to grow your socials using this tool. But remember, this tool is an instant replay, meaning you're supposed to hit the button and watch the replay back. If it's 20, 30 seconds, that's a long clip to be watching back live on stream, unless a lot happened in the past 20 seconds. This time limit is called a buffer, and the reason it's called that is because if you set it to 20 seconds, you're buffering the past 20 seconds of your stream, and when you hit a trigger, you're going to save that past 20 seconds. Now, this doesn't mean Streamlabs has automatically started recording your buffer. No, there is another step you have to do. When you go live, you either have to trigger it manually by clicking this button here, or you can set it up in your settings where it will start automatically when you start streaming. To do this, which I really recommend you do, you're going to want to go to your settings, click General, and then check the automatically start replay buffer when streaming. This means when you go live, as I said, you don't have to trigger the replay button to start automatically. With all that checked, it means that when you hit that go live button, Streamlabs is going to start buffering whatever your time limit was, be it 5 or 20 seconds. And now we just need to find a way to trigger it and play it back on stream. So to do that, all we're going to do is we're going to add an instant replay widget to the scene we choose to use it in. For example, I'm going to be wanting to play back inside my game scene where I'm playing games. I'm going to hit the plus in the source list. I'm going to select the instant replay widget. Any scene that you want to use your replay in will need to have this widget added, and then you're going to need to position it in the source list properly. Personally, I add the widget to the top so it covers everything when I activate it. I'd rather see the playback of myself dying or winning rather than see my current webcam above it. But if you want to, you can place the widget underneath your webcam so that you're constantly just playing your live feed. Now, there are some really fancy ways you can add instant replays that I'm going to be covering at the end of this video, but this is the most basic way to add it. Now we just need to trigger a way to capture the buffer and then to actually activate the replay. We're going to be doing this with hotkeys. Now, there are 2 hotkeys or 3, depending on how you want to do it, that you need to set up. The first is the trigger hotkey, which is what you're going to press to actually save the replay. Now, if we go into Streamlabs and we go to our settings, if we go to hotkeys, we can find the save replay section at the top. I'm going to hotkey mine to mouse 4, but I recommend hotkeying this to a button you don't use for anything else and is close by so you can quickly hit it. Remember, you're only buffering whatever you set your time limit to at the start of this video. Because I set mine to 5 seconds, it means that I can only capture the last 5 seconds when I hit my trigger that I've just set up. 5 seconds isn't that long, so every second I take to get my hand over and press that hotkey means that I'm losing a second from my buffer. Now, the next hotkey you want to add is just designed to reveal the instant replay source that you added to your source list earlier. If you've added it properly, all you have to do is go to your hotkeys. Once you're in your hotkeys section, you're able to go to the scene you added the replay to, for example, my game scene, and you'll want to find Show Instant Replay and Hide Instant Replay. You'll hotkey these to a button you don't use for anything else. For example, Numpad Subtract is what I'm going to use. And when you press that button, it will either turn on the source or turn off the source, depending on what it was set to. You'll want to set your instant replay source to be hidden to start with so you can reveal it later once you clip something. Obviously, if you have a Stream Deck or Stream Deck alternative, you can just set up a button that is very easy to press and reveal that source. But if you have a Stream Deck, you know how to do that, so don't worry. And that is your entire instant replay setup in the most basic form. Now we want to test it before we go live, obviously. So if we get our camera turned on and we open up a game and we look down here in the bottom right, we can click this little button that turns on the replay buffer. Move around a little bit, wave, or make your character jump around or fire some shots, and then quickly press the save replay hotkey that you set up earlier. Now you can press your hotkey to turn the instant replay source on, and if it's all set up correctly, you're going to be able to see your instant replay on your stream. It is super important to remember that your instant replay will only play back the last clip you saved, meaning that every time you press that button, you are going to be overriding whatever will play back in that source. But that doesn't mean you've lost every clip. In fact, it's the opposite. Every time you hit that button to save your buffer, it'll actually save to your PC that clip. I'm going to show you how you can take all those clips and in under 10 minutes, turn it into a highlight reel for your social media at the end of this video. So stay tuned. But before I show you guys that, let's take our instant replays a step further and make them even more unique, which is ironic because now everyone watching this is going to just make them like this and they're going to be less unique. Straight out the gate, let's right-click our replay source and look at our properties. Inside here, we have a few settings that I want to show you. The first is the loop setting. If this is turned off, then once your replay is finished, it will vanish, revealing your normal scene. Note, you'll need to still press the hide source hotkey again before next time, or else it won't work. If your loop is turned on though, it will keep looping the instant replay until you press the hide source hotkey that you set up. Next, we have our speed setting. Now this will either speed up or slow down your playback depending on what you choose. I've set my speed to 50, meaning my 5-second clip goes for 10 seconds, and we can react to it in a sort of slow motion style. Now, if you close your properties and right click your source, you can click filters. Now you can add filters and add a color correction filter, for example. I've then adjusted my saturation to be -1, making my instant replay come back as black and white. Let's hit save on our color correction, and now when you click playback for your instant replay, it'll be black and white slow motion footage, which is great for playing back fails and deaths. You can take this a step further though and set up two different instant replay effects, or even more than that. For example, we can have this black and white slow motion for fails, but then we want full color for victories. To do this, let's start fresh. Remove the filters from your instant replay and delete it from your game scenes. I want you to make a new scene and we're gonna name it Fail Replays. Add your instant replay to that scene, right click the scene, filters, add your filter to the scene instead of the instant replay source. Import this scene as a source. Now, since this is a different source to our instant replay, I need you to go back into your hotkeys and set a new one to activate it on and off as shown earlier. You'll be able to find it though because you named it Fail Replays and it will appear in your scene source list under hotkeys. Now, let's follow the exact same steps, create a new scene and name it Normal Replays, but don't add the filters to the scene. We can hotkey that to a different button once we've imported it, and now we can watch replays in color or black and white depending on what hotkey we press. To add effects such as rain, old-timey overlays, fireworks, or the little VHS replay graphic that we gave you, it is very similar. To do this, all you need to do is make a new scene, name it VHS graphic, you'll add your VHS effect or your rain or whatever you're choosing to do to it as well. Then you're going to import the entire scene into your game scene as we've shown. And of course, you'll set up your hotkey to reveal the scene as I showed earlier. If you want to deep dive into using this effect, for example, I actually have it in another video. I'll have it linked at the top of the description. But with all that done, you should be able to turn all of this on and off and make a very unique instant replay depending on what you're going for. Here is the extra added bonus tip. As I said, every single time you hit that button to save your buffer, you're actually saving that clip directly to your computer. This is fantastic for a lot of different reasons. If I downloaded my Twitch clips, for example, it is going to be a compressed file from Twitch and all of the audio is going to be squished into one track, meaning I can't remove music or I can't remove anything at all, which I've worked hard to separate all of my sources. So when they all get smushed together, it is a pain for editing. But as I said, by hitting that instant replay, it is saving an uncompressed clip with all of the audio tracks, meaning I can pass that off to an editor and he can work with it without any trouble. And the clips that you save won't have any of the black and white, slow motion, or anything like that as well. They will be the raw original instant replays before you added all the filters, which means the editors can work well on them and they can do whatever they want. But you might not have an editor or you might not have any editing practice, and this is where the next step comes in. Once you've finished your stream and you've done a bunch of saving, don't close Streamlabs OBS yet. Go up to the top left and I want you to click on the highlighter button. This is a brand new tool that's only been out of the Streamlabs OBS very recently. And if you look, it'll start loading up every instant replay you took that stream. If you want, you can also upload your own clips from your computer as well, meaning you can upload title cards, graphics, or just generally clips from other streams. This is a quick fire editing program for creating compilations that is built into Streamlabs OBS and is entirely free. Obviously, this won't replace real editing and it isn't overly fancy, but for someone just starting out and for someone wanting to be able to post content on different platforms or just generally get a little bit of a highlight for their community, this is amazing. Once it's loaded up all your clips, you can actually do so much with it. For example, you can drag clips around to change the order they're going to appear in. You can trim them down to show only the best parts and get rid of the fat. You can change the transition type to whatever you want, or upload background music and play with the volume. Once you have it in a way that feels good, you can actually hit preview and it will show you a low res version without having to export or render anything. After looking at the preview, you can make any changes you want and then you hit export. You can pick where it exports, change the name, change the resolution, change the frame rate, and then that's pretty much it. You've got it. You have a whole compilation exported in under 10 minutes. You can take this highlight reel, upload it to YouTube, upload it to Twitter, upload it to wherever you want. And while it might not be VSEO'd and it might not be amazing, at the end of the day, it is extra content, meaning more discoverability. I absolutely love this. But the most important thing that everyone's forgetting is the 100% code word. I want you to comment BAM down in the comments down below and let me know you watched it entirely for your 100% crew badge. I will see you guys next week. I hope this video helped you out. Goodbye.